Hi, my name is Osman Biçer. Welcome to my presentation. Today I'm going to talk about our recent work, Anonymous, Attribute-Based, Decentralized, Secure, and Fair eDonation, a joint work by me and Professor Alptekin Küpçü. The flow of my presentation will go as follows. First, I will define Anonymous, Secure, and Fair, Decentralized eDonation problem. Then I will present the first eDonation scheme that solves this problem, together with its preliminaries and the protocol construction. Suppose that you want to donate some money for the people who are in need of it for some reason. Traditionally, you go to an ICO, give your donation money to that ICO, and tell it the attribute policy choice that you want the recipient of the donation to satisfy. Then the ICO finds those recipients for you and deliver the donation money for you to them. However, there are some problems with this traditional setting. First of all, what about the privacy of the donor? The donor reveals his identity as well as his choice of attribute policy for recipients to the ICO. What about the privacy of the recipients? The recipients reveals their identities and their attributes to the ICOs. How to ensure fair distribution of donations among those recipients? Some recipients may receive more donations, whereas others receive less donations, even though they are in need of more. Although a single ICO can ensure fairness among recipients, since there are multiple ICOs in the real world, a donor might receive donations from multiple of them, which is a problem for fairness. Our fairness notion is based on equality of receivable donations in a given time. However, it can be further improved, as we will discuss later. And the last but not the least problem, what if this ICO turns out to be a malicious party and steals your money? Making donations is a growing sector in the world. More than 180,000 ICOs only in United Kingdom exist, according to Center for Charitable Giving and Philanthropy. More than 2 out of 3 people donate in countries like Indonesia, Australia, New Zealand, United States, Ireland, and United Kingdom, according to CAF 2018 World Giving Index. To solve these issues with the traditional ICO setting, we had some inspiration from historical traditions. One of them is Italian anonymous coffee ordering. Here you go to a coffee shop, give some money for free coffee, then later another person comes to that coffee shop and receives free coffee on behalf of your previous donated money. Another one is Turkish hang free bread. Similar to Italian anonymous coffee ordering, here people put breads into places that everybody can see. Then later, anybody who wants to get free bread goes and take from those places. Based on our inspirations, we imagined a compact system replacing all ICOs. In one system, a person first puts his donation as well as his attribute policy choice for those donations to be received into a place that are seeable by everybody. Then anybody who sees those donations, as long as they satisfy the attribute policy, apply to the system, prove their satisfiability of the attribute policy, and receive the donations. Of course, this system needs to ensure some security properties. One of them is unforgeability and being balanced. The system should be ensured for against any thievery attempts or any forgery attempts. Donor privacy. The system should protect donor's identity, although protecting the attribute policy choice is hard since it needs to be revealed and published for the recipients to apply. We at least want the system to protect donor's identity. Another security requirement is recipient privacy. The recipient should not reveal their identity, but prove anonymously satisfying the attribute policy related to a donation. And of course, this system needs to satisfy fair distribution of donations among the recipients. And again, as I said, our fairness is based on equality of receivable donations in a given time period. The challenges we faced when designing the system is as follows. First of all, since this is the first e-donation system, there was no framework that is defined in the cryptographic literature. And we defined the first e-donation framework with the related security games and algorithms. Then we constructed the e-donation protocol that satisfies the security requirements of the e-donation framework. However, this e-donation protocol required conflicting requirements. One of them is ensuring privacy while preserving the balance. Another one is ensuring fair distribution of donations while preserving privacy. And the last challenge, but not the least, of course, was security proofs. Now let me describe our e-donation scheme, but first let me start with the underlying primitives of our that are used in our e-donation scheme. So the public ledger is one of the primitives that we utilize in e-donation, can be considered as a notebook that everybody can read, but only a ledger writer can write. Therefore, to write onto this notebook, everybody sends what they want to write to the ledger writer. Then the ledger writer checks it according to a predefined policy. And if the policy is satisfied, predefined rules, that if the rules are satisfied, he writes it onto the ledger. Other underlying primitives that we are used were base cache and prif cache schemes. So base cache is an abstraction of the known, well-known cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin or Ethereum. In a base cache tuple, the value and the pseudonym together exists. So they together make up the base cache tuple. The security guarantee related to base cache is balance. So the balance of the parties involved are assumed to be secured by base cache. And another abstraction that we used is prif cache, which is an abstraction of zero coin or zero cache, anonymous, decentralized e-cache. So prif cache is used for anonymously making transactions among people. So it provides two operations. One is prif cache mint for blurring your base cache into a prif cache. Then anonymously spending that prif cache as a base cache of a separate party. These two operations also has related transactions that are resulting from those operations that needs to be sent to the ledger writer after the operation has been executed. The related security guarantees by prif cache is anonymity of the users that make the transactions, and the balance of the involved parties are protected. Another primitive that we utilize in e-donation is attribute-based signatures. They are utilized for proving satisfiability of an attribute policy as a signature on a message. Therefore, they are non-interactive. And the identity of a signer remains anonymous in this signature. Only the satisfiability of an attribute policy is revealed. The user to sign a message first needs to obtain attribute certificates from the authorities. After obtaining the certificates, he can generate the signatures. As the attribute-based signature scheme, we use our recent work, versatile ABS or VABS. The reason why we use this scheme is that it provides usage limitation. That is, in a given time period, the number of signatures that can be generated by a signer can be limited to a certain number. If the signer generates more signature than that, the verifier of the VABS will detect and will not accept those signatures. So, in our e-donation protocol, to join it, a recipient first needs to go to attribute authorities and receive her attribute certificates. For example, this student here first needs to go to income office for receiving this monthly income certificate. Then income office returns her. Sorry for that. Then the income office returns her the attribute certificate. She also goes to her university for her student attribute certificate, and the university then return her the student attribute token. After obtaining her attribute tokens, she is ready to receive donations from the system. So the donation process in our system goes as follows. First, having some money, some base cash in the ledger, the donor makes a pref cash mint transaction to convert it into a pref cash. Then the donor anonymously make the donate transaction, which is actually a pref cash spend transaction to a attribute, to an attribute policy, not to a person. So since here these are unlinkable, the identity of the donor who makes this donate transaction with this attribute policy remains anonymous. And the donate transaction is written on the ledger. Seeing this donate transaction on the ledger, any recipient can then make a claim transaction, which directly references to this donate transaction and is actually a pref cash mint transaction signed with VABS. Therefore, this also means pref cash. And also, since this is signed by VABS, the number of signature by a recipient that can be generatable and can get verified actually can be limited by the ledger writer that needs to check these donations. Together with having donations to be unit amount, this usage limitation can ensure equality of receivable donations in the system in a given time period. And since this is actually a pref cash mint transaction, it blurs the base cash into pref cash, and now anonymously the recipient can spend it to any person that he wants. Now, since they are unlinkable, and since this claim transaction is signed by VABS, the recipient's identity will remain anonymous. And since the recipient of this briefcase spent operation cannot be linked to this donation, although it can be linked to the recipient, recipient's attribute policies will remain private. To conclude, we have constructed the generic e-donation framework that can be usable beyond our e-donation protocol in the future e-donation protocols as well. We also constructed an efficient, practical, and provable secure e-donation scheme, which is the first e-donation scheme in the cryptographic literature. As future work, our e-donation protocol can be improved as the definition of fairness, for example, based on adjustments based on location, or adjustments based on the attributes of the recipients. So it can be improved instead of being equal, some different fairness notions are possible here. Designs that do not rely on single authorities for attributes should also be obtained in the upcoming future. Since our e-donation system targets decentralization and the whole donation process is although decentralized, here the attributes are obtained from authorities, and this can be improved by, for example, threshold issuing of attributes or another method. Another improvement is also related to efficiency. Although we think our e-donation protocol is practical enough, of course there are always room for improvements in efficiency, together with maybe primitives, underlying primitives, or another separate e-donation protocol that is more efficient, is also achievable. Thank you very much for listening. I would like to hear a lot any of your questions.